New Yorkers are seeing extra police presence at the airports, the bridges, the subways in our city. The New York Police Department says it is just a precaution, but we are also seeing extra security down at Ground Zero today, the site where, of course, thousands of people lost their lives on September the 11th. And I'm very honored to be joined now by Ernest Strada, who is the father of one of those victims, Thomas Strada, who was a broker for Kenner Fitzgerald. His son, Thomas's son, his baby, was born just 4 days before the attack. And Thomas had to spend months getting the nursery ready, and he was just a wonderful family man and one of the so many of these personal stories. Ernest, it's been so nice just having you here as we talk about all of this. And you know, for the families, I'm wondering what your reaction was when you heard, after these 10 years almost, that bin Laden was dead.
It's hard to describe the reaction. In my mind, at times was dead and at times was alive. Mm-hmm. So it's with mixed feelings today. It's sort of bittersweet, if you will. I'm a Christian, a devout Christian. I've turned my cheek the other way my whole life. This incident and the loss in my family hardened me to some degree. To a large degree, it hardened me. I was ready to pick up a gun and go hunt him myself. I'm forever indebted, and so is this country, to the brave men and women of the armed forces who fight for our liberty, and for that team that went in and did what they did over the weekend or over the last couple of days. It's just phenomenal. The reaction in this country is one that I would have never expected, because after 10 years, so many people tend to forget, except for the many, many families who had the huge loss that they've had. Some people tend to forget. I think this has brought a renewed energy with regard to who we are, what we are, why we are as a nation, and for that I'm happy. This won't bring Tommy back to us, but to some degree it gives us some satisfaction with regard to having the world rid of this monster. It's really ironic. I thought of it a little while ago, that within a space of a couple of days, we see the birth of almost a saint or an angel in Pope John, and now the death of a devil. So life works in strange ways, doesn't it?
Yeah, it sure does. I'm wondering how significant it is for you, because President Obama had a decision to make. They could either, you know, take a B-2 stealth bomber and obliterate this entire place. And they chose to do it the hard way, to put men on the ground and make sure that Osama bin Laden saw that it was American soldiers who came to take his life. How important and how satisfying, I know it's kind of a, you know, sick way in some ways to look at it, but how much does that mean to you?
No, it's not a sick way to look at it. I've thought about what we had to do, why we have to do it, an awful lot. I'm a staunch advocate of enhanced interrogation. I believe firmly in the Patriot Act. I believe firmly in Gitmo and what the media does and what some of the elements of this country do displeases me. It angers me at times. This is proof that you have to continue to pursue what is right in this world and in your life. And making the decision, I don't know that it was a difficult decision. The president who served us at the time of the incident sort of made a pledge. He was unable to fulfill that pledge. But as a nation, we have a responsibility to fulfill the pledge. And the men and women who achieved the goal and has satisfied the hearts and minds of a lot of people, not all of them. There'll be people who are skeptics because nobody has seen that body. He was given a burial within 24 hours of his death, which may please some people, but anger a lot of people.
How do you feel about that?
Well, it's really hard for me to feel a closure, you know, a real closure. Is it morbid to say you want to see someone dead or see some dead body? It's hard for me.
You want to see the picture, though.
Well, I want to see.
I
want to be absolutely sure. Absolutely sure. And then you have to think that we still have Khalid Sheikh Mohammed running around, free and easy as a bird, enjoying the life that he's enjoying 10 years later, while this country and the people who have suffered the loss, have had to bear a sorrow. They say they buried this monster at sea. They could have buried him in the tears of the people that we shared over these 10 years. There would have been enough to bury him in, believe me. So I don't know. Tommy lives with our family, with his wife, with his children every day of the week, I'm sure. And maybe it's a little easier to carry the loss now that you know that he's gone, or the person responsible for Tommy's death and the death of so many other beautiful men and women has finally met his own. But I'm really not sure.
Well, Mr.
Strada, I'll still search for what I want to find, but I don't know if I'll ever find it before I'm gone.
I know you said there's a tremendous void that stays in your life, and when I sit here with you, I can feel that, and I know that this could have happened yesterday, probably, for all that your family has been through, and we're so grateful to you for being here today, because it's so important that everybody out there who may have forgotten any of this understands the pain that your family's gone
through. Terry wanted to be with me today, was on her way and got caught in traffic at the Lincoln Tunnel, so we will get together, we'll embrace in some way, and today is a special day for a lot of people.
It is.
I don't know that it's that special for me, personally.
Well, we wish you peace in some way in this
at some point.
And we thank you so much for being with us today.
I thank
it's
you very much
pleasure,
for the opportunity.
It's our pleasure to be with you and to meet you, Mr. Strada.
Thank you
very
so
much.